Dear students, today I am going to discuss unbalanced wheatstone bridge, because you know in balanced wheatstone bridge we can easily simplify the circuit. But in order to solve the unbalanced wheatstone bridge, we have various techniques, but right now I want to discuss only one technique, that is symmetry technique. When there is a symmetrical circuit, how would you apply the symmetry? In order to do that, you have to assume fictitious battery here. At terminal A, let I am taking 100 volt. At terminal A, I am taking fictitious voltage, that is 100 volt. There is no effect at all on the answer if you assume any type of the voltage. And at the second terminal, I am taking 0 volt. Let this is 0 volt. And I want to complete the fictitious battery by this way. This is positive terminal and this is negative terminal. This is 100 volt. One terminal of the battery having 100 volt and there have 0, net potential difference is 100 volt. Now you have to assume here, you have to assume any number at this junction as well as at this junction. Let at junction this particular, I am assuming x potential. Therefore, at this particular junction, potential will be 100 minus x. I think you have understood it. Is 100? 100 minus x, that is 100 minus x over this junction. Now, we know at a particular junction, total charge, sum of the charge, and as well as total charges remains conserved. If total charges remains conserved, I can write at x total charge, change in charge, total charge is conserved, it means change in charge will be 0. What do you mean by it? It means at junction x, if you add all the charges, whatever charges are there across the 3 microfarad capacitor, across 2 microfarad capacitor and across 4 microfarad capacitor, its change will be 0 and total charge is constant. Constant means final and initial value will be 0. Change means final minus initial, and that will be 0. Now you should apply right from the 2 microfarad capacitance. And then what is charge? Charge is Cv. C is capacitance and V is potential across that capacitance. If I write here 2, across the 2 I can write x is potential difference, and plus if you take 4, potential difference become this is x and this is 100 minus x, and finally I can write x minus, this is x, x minus 100 plus x. By this way I can write the potential difference. Plus 3 is the capacity of capacitor and potential across it is x minus 100. By this way, I can write sum of the charge change will be 0 at junction x. When you solve this, 2x, 4x, xx will cancel, 2x plus 3x, 2x plus 3x, that is 6x, 6x plus 4x, 10x, 10x plus 3x, that is 13x. Now this will be 13x, which is equal to 100, 400, 400 plus 300, that is 700. And finally, x will be 700 upon 700 upon 30. 700 upon 30. This is the value of x. Now charge flow, I can write charge flow how much charge is flowing through the circuit. That will be delta Q, which is equal to 2x plus 3 into 100 minus x. When you substitute the value of x in this equation, you will get delta q will be 2 into 700 upon 30 plus 3 into 100 minus 700 upon 13. Whatever result you are getting, you can solve it. But our aim is to calculate the net capacity between A and B in this complicated circuit. Net capacity means total charge flown through the circuit divided by total potential difference. Total potential difference is 100 volt. If you put all these values, 2 into 700 upon 30 plus 3 into 100 minus 700 upon 30 whole divided by 100, answer will be 14 upon 13 plus 18 upon 13. Now, further you can simplify it by 13, and further it can be what is LCM? 13 is LCM, 14 plus 18. Final answer between A and B capacity is 32 upon 13 microfarad. This will be the answer.